hope you're all doing well. So, great story that I'd love to get into. So, but for those of you who are new, welcome. My name is Dr. Evan Hirsch. I specialize in helping people with chronic fatigue get their lives back, achieve the best energy of their lives. And I'm doing that from this by educating in this free Facebook group, by my book, which you can get on Amazon, and then my one-on-ones and group coaching. So let's dive into the topic here. So I was getting ready to cut my hair. As you can see, my hair is a lot shorter than it was, and I had a little bit of an accident. And so I was getting ready to cut my hair. And what I do is I squat in front of the toilet so that I can get all the hair in there so it doesn't get in the sink and whatever. And I was listening to my new laundry center, my washing machine, and I was really enjoying it. And the reason why is because it was new, and we'll talk about that in a second. And so I wasn't really paying attention whether there was a guard on my clippers or not. And it turns out, I went, nope, and there was no guard on my clippers. And so I had a reverse mohawk where I was kind of, you can still maybe see that it is shorter in the middle than it was on the sides. My daughter says that I should never start going down the middle, but then I ran around the house and showed my wife and daughter what I did, and we all laughed about it, and then I came back, put a one on it, and shaved it up. But the reason why it happened was because I was distracted because of my new laundry center. So the reason why I got a new laundry center, which for those of you who don't know is a combo washer dryer, where kind of like you have in condos or apartments, they're a little bit smaller, but they're top loading washers and then the front loading dryers. So the reason why this is important, just to back up a moment, is that my energy started to flag a little bit. My energy started to come down a little bit. And I always like to do evaluations of my home and of my family and stuff like that. So I did a bunch of testing and I found that I had mold in my home. And so I had an ERMI test of 10 and we want it to be less than 2. And this is a DNA test that I recommend that looks at the amount of mold DNA that is present in the home. And so when I did that test, then I knew that I had to figure out what was going on, where it was coming from. So I invited in Jason Kester from Kester Clear. That's K-E-S-T-E-R. He's up in Seattle and does the West Coast, and he's amazing at what he does. And he came in to evaluate the home and figure out exactly where the issue is coming from and to make some any other recommendations that he had. And so we were in the process already. We already had some idea about what was going on. And so we knew that we needed to replace our porch. So we're in the process of doing that. And I've had several clients who have had significant mold on their porches. And once they've replaced their porch or torn off the moldy sections, it's made a huge difference in their energy and removing the mold out of their system. So that's the first thing, is making sure that there is no mold on the outside of the house that is significant. So that was the porch. The other thing that we knew was that we were going to remediate our basement. So we recently went with ductless air and heat, and so we have ducted system in the basement that aren't sealed 100%. And so anything that's in the basement, and we have a mud bottom basement, anything that's in the basement was going to come up into the home. And so we are planning now, we're going to pull out all that ducting and we're going to seal those the entrances into the home where those vents are. So that's the other thing. Then Jason said, you definitely want to check under your refrigerator to make sure, because there is a drop tray that can get mixed with dust, or a water drop tray, I should say, that can get mixed with dust that can cause an issue. And so we pulled that out, we looked, and in ours, it was actually embedded inside, so we weren't able to view it, and it's going to be more secure, as opposed to one that's sitting right there on the bottom of the floor that has the dust in it. And so, very important to double check that. And then we looked at our sink, and he said we had to provide some caulking around the sink. And then he looked at our washing machine, and we had front load washers, and I'd heard this before, but I couldn't tell that we had mold inside our washer, and he said we definitely did. So front loading washers are notoriously bad for growing mold. It's near impossible unless you buy certain brands, actually one brand, the Asko brand, A-S-K-O, from Sweden or somewhere in Europe, to avoid getting mold on the inside rim. The top loaders are much better. Now, we don't have space for two top loading machines, so that's why we ended up going with the laundry center. So that's why I had this this myth with my hair, because I was so appreciative of that. So there's some tips there. Very important to make sure that your home is evaluated. So once we're done with this process, oh, and then the other thing is he recommended that we change some of the levels or the settings that we have on the IQ air filter. So there's only one air filter that I recommend for getting at mold toxins. So there's mold spores that can float around and that can be gobbled up by any HEPA filter. But mold toxins or mycotoxins are 0.03 microns in size. And the IQ air filter, that's iqair.com, are the only ones that I have found that do the job at really getting rid of the mycotoxins. Now, he said that when you're not in the home or when you don't mind it being on a higher level, it should be on the max, which is at 6, which is a little bit louder. But when you're home, it should be at a 3 or 4 level. So we weren't doing this, and so we modified that as well. So those were the recommendations that he made. So once we complete these remediations, we are going to repeat our ERMI test, our DNA test for mold, and we're going to see where we're at. The other thing that I did is I also checked for mold in the urine of the family members, and we all had some. So we're going to also go through a process of binding up the mold and pulling it out, like I discuss in my book and the online course. So I hope this was helpful for you guys. If you found this helpful, please give it a thumbs up. If you're watching this on YouTube, please subscribe to our channel. And then share away. If you know of somebody who needs this kind of help, please share with them so that you can help me on my mission to help 1 million people resolve their chronic fatigue. Because it's not about what the cause is. It's about what all of the causes are. For those of you who haven't heard me speak before, there are 15 different causes of chronic fatigue, and we all have multiple causes, and we all have different multiple causes. That's why it's so important to assess and determine exactly what your causes are. Thanks for watching, and have an amazing day.